So, ladies and gentlemen, the topic of my presentation addresses the atomic mechanism of instability and failure of nano elements and development of this basis and approach to predicting their lifetime. Currently, the specific feature of nanophysics and nanotechnology development is the transition from the first step, which was the search for nanostructure with exceptional physical and mechanical properties, to the second one, the main purpose of which is the practical use of these properties in nanoelements and nanoproducts. At this stage, the lifetime of nanoelements comes to the fore. Solving all these problems is a challenge for micromechanics and requires fundamentally new approaches which should take into account the specific feature of structure of this object and mechanics of their failure. Namely, first of all, extremely small size of nanoelements, which creates enormous difficulties for experimental investigation, exceptionally test for durability. Second, reaching the limiting state of nanoelements is associated with the individual atomic bond break or with atomic rearrangement. All this requires the use of statistical methods. Additional specific feature is that atomic bonds breaking induced by thermal fluctuation occur under the mechanical load condition. This creates significant difficulties for the use of classical model based on the Arrhenius theory of reaction. Although the need to take into account quantum mechanical effects. All the above are the serious challenge for nano and micro mechanics. So the aim of the report is analysis of key mechanisms governing the lifetime of nanoelements, as well as to presence and approach for predicting the lifetime of nanoelements, consisting of one- and two-dimensional structure. We will consider this problem by example of carbon graphene nanoelements. First of all, it's due to the fact that carbon and graphene are considered a basic element for creating all carbon-based nanoelectronics. Moreover, carbon graphene nanoelements are typical strain-tronic elements, which can be used in particular in optoelectronic device with tunable wavelengths. In this case, the force effect is of paramount importance. So, next issue will be considered in this presentation. First of all, it's a fluctuation model of instability of atomic interaction and atomic bond break. The atomic mechanism of failure will be considered analyzed, and for this, the results of DFT calculation was used. Synergism of the effect of temperature and mechanical load of the lifetime of carbon will be considered. And at the end of the report, the main factors governing lifetime will be briefly discussed, as well as the quantum mechanical effect. As I have said, extremely small size of nanoelements give rise to considerable difficulties in experimental investigation. But on the other side, this makes possible widely use of numerical methods, such as molecular dynamics simulation, first principle simulation, or DFT calculation. Molecular dynamics simulation seems a direct approach to the problem, but unfortunately it covers timescale which doesn't exceed several microseconds. For nano device, a prediction is required for much longer time interval, which are measured in years. And in this situation, conventional approach to solve this problem is to use Arrhenius model. However, it contains a fitting constants for determination of which the experimental data are needed for nanosystems is associated with considerable difficulties. The adapted version of transition state theory partly overcomes these difficulties. Unfortunately, this theory is valid only for unloaded systems. As noted earlier, from the practical point of view, it is important to predict lifetime of nanoelements under the action of force field. In this connection, we proposed the fluctuation model that takes into account the specific feature of this object. According to this model, a fluctuation critical value is required for the atomic bond break, and the magnitude of the critical fluctuation is not constant, its value predetermined by the level of applied force. Such approach enables to predict the probability of contact bond breaking during the one oscillation of the atom, and determine the total probability of failure for the specified time. This enables to obtain the expression for the bond break time with a given probability of realization. Absence of fitting constant is one of the features of this model, because the parameters of atomic interaction are determined by the DFT calculation. The DFT calculation were also used to analyze the regularities atomic bond breaking and the phenomenon of steep decrease in the resistance to tension was found as the invariable value of the nanoelement length. However, in this case, the atomic bonds don't break. After the rearrangement of atomic structure, the contact bonds is restored and the nanoelements resist further tension. It should be noted that instability of the contact bonds give rise to a release of the elastic energy accumulated in the system during the tension. As consequently, we have a region where the equilibrium position of atoms are impossible, so-called instability zone. The amount of energy accumulated in the system is one of the factors influencing the width of this region. Therefore, its value depends bond of the number of atoms in a chain and magnitude of the applied force. Appearance of instability zone is a key factor governing the kinetic of bond breaking and value of nanoelements lifetime at the thermal fluctuation failure of carbine. Because the thermal fluctuation can result in a release in elastic energy in the loaded carbine nanoelement. It facilitates significantly of atomic bond break. Depending on the position of applied force, relatively the instability zone, we have two mechanisms of failure. First of all, it's a high energy mechanism, where the applied force is less when the applied force is less than the lower bound of instability zone. In this case, the magnitude of critical fluctuation depends on the value of the load value. And low energy mechanism, where the applied force lies within in the instability zone. In this case, much smaller fluctuation can result in bond break. These two mechanisms determining both the regularities of time dependence of strength and the absolute value of lifetime of carbine nanoelements. So, lifetime might change from years in region A to seconds in region B. The existence of low energy mechanism and accordingly extremely small lifetime nanoelements in B region are manifestation of synergism of stress and temperature. The presence of instability zone is the cause of such synergy. This feature gives a quantitatively illustration of the synergies. It presents lifetime dependence calculated with and without taking into account its stability zone, blue and dashed line respectively. The total effect of temperature and mechanical stress can lead to significant decrease in the lifetime from millions of years to milliseconds. To verify the proposed fluctuation model, we use the results of molecular dynamic simulation of tension of carbon graphene nanoelements containing 10-atom carbon chains at this temperature. Despite the fact that the molecular dynamic methods covers a relatively small time scale, for this temperature we succeeded to obtain the value of lifetime to the contact bond break with the region of realization both low energy and high energy mechanics. And that, according to the simulation, is results transition from the first mechanics to the second occur at this relatively low, 0.74. This value agrees well with the fluctuation model prediction. It should be noted that this is currently no satisfactory potential for molecular dynamic simulation of such object. Therefore, to verify the fluctuation, our fluctuation model, we use the modified Reber 2 potential for molecular dynamic simulation. Unfortunately, this potential underestimates the binding energy, so it can only be used to compare the prediction of fluctuation model and molecular dynamics. To predict the real lifetime of carbon graphene nanoelements, the fluctuation model has used strain diagrams obtained by a DFT calculation. In other words, in this case, we used results of DFT calculation. This figure presents the dependence of waiting time for contact bond breaking of nanoelements on the value of load for the for two temperature. According to this data, the lifetime of carbon graphene nanoelements with 10-atom carbon chains is quite sufficient for this practical use at temperature not exceeding 600 up to 1000 kelvins. These results are obtained for nanoelements containing 10 atoms carbon chain. In general, the lifetime depends on whether atom number is the chain. In other words, we have even odd effects. Moreover, the mechanical load increases. As the mechanical load increases, we have inversion of the even odd effects. At loads less than 30%, of the strength of the contact bond, nanoelements with even carbon chains are more durable. Under greater loads, on the contrary, odd nanoelements have a longer lifetime. This means that nanoelements with odd carbon chains should be used for the strain-tronics element. The existence of even odd effect for the strength and binding energy is the cause of this effect for lifetime. The inversion even odd effect with increasing load is induced by the transition from the high energy mechanics of breaking the bond to the low energy one. So, in conclusion, and I would like to emphasize the following points. First of all, it is existence of two mechanisms of the contact bond breaking, low energy mechanism and high energy mechanism, is a key factor determining the regularities of the effect of mechanical law on the lifetime of carbine graphene nanoelements, and second, presence of instability zone is a reason for existence of these two mechanisms. It also causes synergism effect of temperature and mechanical load on the lifetime. And quantum mechanical nature of the lifetime of carbon graphene nanoelements is manifestation in existence even odd effect. However, the inversion of even odd effect under the action of mechanical loading is the most interesting from physics point of view, and this is also important for strengthronic applications. In general, the proposed fluctuation model enables to account for the main regularities of failure of nanoelements. Calculations show that lifetime of carbon graphene nanoelements is quite sufficient for their practical use in nano device at temperature not higher than 600 or up to one. Thank you for your attention.